Haley says she's always wanted to see what this thing can do on this scale. So for that, I think we need to take it surfing. For your next qualifier, you'll need to prove you can take on the water flumes at high speed. Let's go. Hit it! Remember, surfing is all about balance. First flume coming right up. Like you're going back to school at the academy. You're a pro rank now. Oh, and you can keep the Diora.
You made it through the qualifier. You are now officially an academy pro. I've added all the new events to your schedule. Something tells me you're gonna love these. How would you like to learn a bit more about Hot Wheels? Wanna learn about the famous orange track?
Absolutely. Be there soon.
Now that you're pro rank, we're ready to take the faster cars out of the garage. Don't get me wrong, we're going to hit some eye-watering speeds up here, but we have to do this carefully. Time you rank up at the academy, I'll let you drive faster and faster cars.
There's something really special about taking a bunch of professional drivers, grouping them up into teams, and having them race. If you ever just want to race, Horizon Tour is your answer.
don't have to pay for fast travel here at the park. The Hot Wheels people know how to carry cars around.
This is a speed race, my favorite. Track machines and precision handling. Like my asphalt racing program, except bigger and more orange. Got a towel? This race has a load of water flume tracks. Lots of water, lots of speed, lots of fun.
Come on, let's take this monster for a spin. Careful. Technically, that's more than 1,400 brake horsepower you've got there. As I said, Hot Wheels have always been designed to go really fast on custom tracks. So, what do you do with the track? Well, you make it in segments so people can build whatever they like. Then you invent a battery-powered booster to shoot cars along the straight and a speed brake to slow them down for tight turns. You can even tune how fast the booster will propel the cars. But why stop there? Loops, jump ramps, bank turns, gravity drops, trestle bridges, chicanes, crossovers, lap counters, multi-lane side-by-side racing launches. All fully compatible, of course. That's just good engineering. They even made an auto shop with a working dyno and a teeny tiny oil can and wrench to tune up your cars. I've played with it.
Nice. So why is the track orange?
It's like bright orange.
Can't argue with that.
As you know, nothing is more exciting than seeing cars racing side by side. Hot Wheels made loads of accessories for this, including launchers for the start line, speedometers to clock the speed of passing cars, and finish gantries that could show which car had won. No cheating allowed! In the 70s, there were dedicated multi-lane track pieces, including the Fat Track, which was three lanes wide and had no dividers for a risky overtake. Nowadays, there's even more fun stuff to play with. You've got figure eights, multi-story garages, rubber band kickers, and even giant sharks and dinosaurs that jump on the track. Why else do you think we got a giant dragon right here at the park? So, why make your cars go really fast on plastic track?
I give up. Why?
So they go further when they jump off the end, of course.
Come on, let's go.
This is going to be epic. I'm riding along with you for this bit. About that one. It's time to learn about the greatest rivalry in Hot Wheels history. Meet me here. Snake or Mongoose? Come on down, I'll explain. Alejandra says she wants to organize another qualifier. Keep earning those medals and you'll get another invite very soon.
Working on it, Hayley.
You're probably wondering what all this snake and mongoose talk is about, right? You take the yellow car, I'll take the blue. I'll explain along the way. You've heard of Don Prudhomme and Tom McEwen, right? They were famous NHRA drag racers in the 70s, who had a friendly rivalry going on for years. Don was a four-time National Hot Rod Association champ and Motorsport Hall of Famer. He was nicknamed the Snake. And Tom McEwen was another dragster who won the NHRA US Nationals. They called him the Mongoose. They were both well-established racers in their own right. As the two of them competed in the US Nationals over the years, they crossed paths numerous times, which sparked a friendly rivalry between them. Mattel proposed to make a series of toys based on the rivalry between the Snake and the Mongoose.
The Hot Wheels sponsorship led to all kinds of drag-themed stuff. Hot Wheels came out with all kinds of new lines back then. You had sets like the Rod Runner and the Big Belter, which launched cars with rubber bands. The Big Belter could even detect jump starts, which is pretty cool, right? These were a smash hit and propelled both Hot Wheels and drag racing to greater levels of fame. Heavyweights were designed to go faster on gravity drops, and Sizzlers had little battery-powered motors, so you didn't need a launcher. Started drawing six-wheel designs like Six Shooter and Open Fire. Hot Wheels didn't stop there. There were loads of other innovations like tempo printing patterns on the cars, which no one else was doing. Then you had the Hot Wheels Collector's Club kit, where you could mail in to get either the Boss Puff, Heavy Chevy, or King Cuda, all with open hoods, big supercharger blowers, and silver paint jobs. Oh, so cool. Wish I'd been around back then. You know what? All this talk about drag racing has given me an idea.
The cars in the original Snake vs. Mongoose set were powered by rubber bands. These ones, well, aren't. How about you and I test them in a drag race?
Okay. Bring it on, Hayley.
Time to see if that snake has a bite. Coming up on a loop. Keep your car in the middle. Keep your foot down. Let me worry about the physics.
I obviously let you win, though. Who else am I going to give the keys to the Rip Rod?
Qualifier 3 is live. I've helped Ale with some of the logistics. It's gonna be a good one.
Qué onda, amigo? I have everything ready for the next qualifier. Now, where is my future Hot Wheels legend?
On my way.